Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Wake up, Link.
Hey guys, I am Crouton Nagiri, and I'd like to welcome you all to my Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild playthrough. I'm a huge Zelda fan, so I'm really excited for this game. Hope you guys enjoy it.
That is a Sheikah Slate. Take it. It will help guide you after your long slumber.
I haven't watched any Let's Plays for this game. Mysterious tablet with a glowing center. So, this is my first time playing it. I haven't seen anything about it except for the tech demo. So I know like a little bit about the first part of the game, but that's it. And this is my first time playing it. Well, I had some problems with Elgato, so it's like my second or third time playing it, but I've only played like the first 15 minutes of it. Barrel. So I heard you can throw any item in this game, so that's cool. It's kind of like Dead Rising, but Zelda.
Hold the Sheikah Slate up to the pedestal. That will show you the way.
Also my first Let's Play ever, so if you guys have any tips for me, leave them in the comments. This game is beautiful.
Link, you are the light. Our light. That must shine upon Hyrule once again. Now go.
Style in this game. It's like a good mix between Wind Waker and Twilight Princess. I guess it's kind of like how Skyward Sword was, but that game sucked. Not really. Sorry to all the Skyward Sword fans out there. I beat it. It was okay. There's the old man, like in the original Legend of Zelda. I've been playing the original Legend of Zelda in prep for this game. Mushroom. Alright, I'm not gonna play this game, Nikki. There we go. heard from a friend that the weapons in this game break really easily, so gonna be stocking up on whips. At least until the second half of the game or something like that. Apple. Take this guy's baked apple. I'm gonna make this first episode kinda long, since there's a lot of opening stuff I gotta do. I'm gonna get right to the end of the first shrine. End of the first shrine, yeah.
Ooh.
So yeah, I guess like this game's based in like the game over timeline or so I hear. So it's like, I guess like in Ocarina of Time? Like you died and had a game over and then Ganon became like a nuclear bomb and made the world apocalyptic. Oh, junk! I found him. Kuruk. Seems like they reused a lot of the art from like Wind Waker, or like at least the styles, and then the sound effects too. I'm supposed to get. There we go. Yes?
Link.
Yes? Who is it?
Head for the point marked on the map in your Sheikah slate.
Yeah, I'm gonna be saving that rusty sword for later. And the axe. Oh, this game's so. Oh, jellies! Gelatinous substance that came from a choo-choo. Okay. That looks so cool. Right. Stuff's for. I'm just gonna hold off on checking all that out. Treasure. More pants. Alright, so the shrine is over there. Yeah. gonna kill, these guys and steal their dinner. Oh, and there's some bow guys around here. Right there they are. Steal their bows. Yeah, but so you guys can see how fast those the weapons break. Look, you kill 1.5 guys and they're gone. My friend was saying they got that from Minecraft. I don't know if that's true or not though. Oh, right, this part. This part's funny. It's like, watch out, please watch out for falling rocks. And then you just fucking pass out. A cell phone, iPhone 7.
Try to remember. You have been asleep for the past 100 years. Gains its true power, this world will face its end. Now then, you must hurry, Link, before it's too late.
So another thing I heard from my friend is that this whole game's like mainly flashbacks to your forgotten memories. Uh-oh. Oh. My, my. I wonder what that could mean. Oh, I should have said dot, dot, dot. Oh, man. Oh, well. Or no, this is the part where I need to say dot, dot, dot. There we go. I don't think any of that matters, but... I don't know if this game's gonna be like Skyrim, like how everybody's interactable. I don't even know if there's really that many CPU like friendly characters in this game. In a second, they give you like a bunch of snarky options. You make Link a real sass factory.
Oh.
Hand it over. Yeah, so there's missions, kind of like how Skyrim is. Just like awkwardly posing behind him. So I skipped through that really fast, but it said like that the treasure in here is the paraglider. All right. So that shrine's as far as I've played, and I'm pretty sure it's also as far as I've seen the game played too. So after that, it's all new. I remember, though, at this part, I can't use up that much stamina or I'll drown. You can't even swim across this little puddle pond thing. Kinda weak. Oh well, though. This is gonna be kind of like a boring, sort of a boring first episode. Oops, I skipped that on accident, I'm sorry. There's like 300 of those, though, so it's not like it really makes that much of a difference. Excuse me. Oh, this game's so awesome. All right. This is kind of cool. I forgot how to do it, though. Oh, so that's how I do that, though. Oh, and I can throw that. All right, cool. All right, but yeah, that's how you do it. Enough to float on water. Never loses tension. Last time I think I got some screws that never get shredded. And I was like, damn man, I could have used that for my job. My old job. This part's so neat. This game's gonna be super neat. Alright, so yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it. That's the whole first temple. Or shrine. He's like a little Sheikah Buddhist monk mummy. Paraglider, please. Paraglider, please. Oh my god. It's like, just make him sound rude as hell. Rude.
Ooh.
Should have said paraglider, please. Betcha the Master Sword's in the Forest of Spirits. Something tells me. Just call it a hunch. Alright, thanks guys for watching my first YouTube video, and let me know what your favorite Zelda game is in the comments. Bye!